I see. Oh my god. Is that a really big one by him? Oh. Female Tornak? Is that the queen? I don't have a lot of mana left. You know what? I'm gonna give her some mana. Because we don't have health potions. But we do have mana potions. I hope we can just keep up with this crap. I wouldn't be surprised if she's throwing, like, magical kind of abilities at us. Could be anything, even just poison. So let's, put up our anti-magic wall, if at all possible. Spell points 4. Points 3. Oh, we do have healing potions, just 2 of them. That I did not know. Alright, so Selena only does a little bit of damage with that bow anyway. Use the spell points 3 on Sabine. Wait a second, what did I do? I'm trying to do, you know what though? Whirlwind. Yeah, let's do whirlwind on them. She'll just attack this time, this one. She's doing that, okay. Oh, that gave Sabine a lot more. Let's see what this one in the back does. Female Tornak moves. Oh boy. They're deflecting. 48. 51 on Valden. Ah, my spell failed. I'll try again, just in case. I don't know what they're gonna do, so. 185, 239, okay. Medium healing. Who had the spell points 3? Yeah, give her another one. That gives us plenty. She'll use that on Valden. I mean, Nelvin. Oh, I keep calling him Valden. Whirlwind. Hopefully we'll get rid of 2 of these quick enough. I don't know what the queen does. It's gotta be harder. Or the female, whatever. Female Tornak. 53, 72. Alright, she attacks pretty much like the other one so far. Agile is pretty screwed up. Valden, 4, 1. Oh, they're both attacking Valden. Oh my god, Agile? Ooh! Oh my god! Medium heal. I'm backing Balden off. And we got the magic going. We're attacking this one, right? Well, then back off. Okay. Oh my god. Crap. He's dead. Sleep? Actually could work like this if they can't advance because of me standing there. And knock on wood, I'm still not damaged. We can't resurrect in combat. This way we can tackle one at a time, we'll resurrect him after. See if this works. I've been deflecting with my ring. I'm guessing that's what it is. Oh, it moves up! Nope! I didn't realize she could move into that space. I tried to put one to sleep. I don't even know if that happened. Who's it going to go after? Sabine or Selena? Let's move Sabine. We need the healer most of all. I can just try to kite back and forth. This is crazy. Whirlwind again. On doing it. I see Balden, I forget. You can attack from back here. Did it say something was broken? Her bow was broken? Okay, missed. Oh, one's down. Right? Wasn't there four of them? Nice. Alright. Her bow broke. And that's our only one. Yeah, I don't deal with that. Wait, what's this? Elf bow. We have an extra elf bow. Okay, we'll just give her that. We'll continue on. Oh, we're running out of magical arrows for her. Now we got more arrows? We had so many at one point. Here we go. She can't take that many. Any other stacks, actually? It's just that. Because at one point, we were all holding arrows for her. Well, I'm actually glad we can still get into his inventory. These numbers go too fast. Yeah. Alright, we gotta move her again. Just kite back and forth. Kill that. Kill that. Whirlwind. If we can keep her at bay like that, that would work. Actually, move him over a little, because we need more leeway. She missed again. She's going for the cleric. Cleric is faster, so I'll move her back over. It'll attack where she was. The other problem is if it changes his mind and decides to start going for Selena, that could be a problem, especially if Sabina's standing right there. If I move her this way, well, that might be a good idea, actually. If I move Sabine this way instead, then I could easily move Selena out of the way, rather than having Sabine stand right next to her. Alright. So let it be done. Alden can attack again. Throw another whirlwind. Keep missing, haha. Like it. Yeah, they're doing no damage to us because of this. So since it can only reach Selena at this point, I'm gonna move Selena. The last whirlwind. This one must be almost dead. Missed. I'll thrash you good. Nice. There's one left. Move Selena back over. Attack. I'm moving over. Attack. Throw a fireball. Got all of one left. Actually, I'm curious to see how much this thing has, so let's show monster LP. Ah, spell failed. I insist on showing the monster LP. Wind Howler, yeah, Wind Howler. go. Right up the butt. Whoa! It still has 416 hit points, this thing. Now we can track its hit points, or her hit points. Attacking Citrine, only 35 and 26. What, does blind work? Blind might have worked. I wish we could mouse over and see, you know, say blind or something. Alright, so it's attacking Citrine now. He's just gonna miss like crazy. It's alright. Medium healing. I still have 7 left. Fully healed. Sixty-3. 19. Not too bad. So I think too much for a small heal. Oh, don't heal the Tornak. If it let me do that, yeah. That would be fair, but no, don't heal the Tornak. 28. 36. I think I'm just gonna do a small heal this time. Healing, fully healed, good thing. 45 and 41. 86 damage. These things are brutal. I hope this one drops something. Maybe a child skeleton. Nah, I hope something better than that. At least they've been giving us XP, not like 5 XP like those stupid curse wasps. Medium healing. Oh, we're starting to run low on the medium healing. Critical hit, Valden, nice! That's her broken bow right there. Sabine, level 37, with 202 life points, 525 power points, 163 spell learning points, 185 training points. This isn't what we left behind, this is Selena's broken bow here. Okay. Not enough. No effect here, right? Resurrection. Agile, what's for dinner? We can feast on these monster corpses if you like. close enough. Glad you're back among the living. So save as another new file here, 163. All right, I'm gonna actually look around in here. Is that another saliva gap? Oh, there's another, there's a drop down there, a pit. I call it a drop down. Destination there. Nope. Now we came from there, yep. So what about this way? To the west. East. Here, maybe? Doesn't look that different, right? It's still an irregular shape. Yeah, that's just gonna lead back there. You know, it's funny. It doesn't have an exit this time. It's supposed to say exit here. Now let me see, I'm not sure we should be able to use the rope to go down. Levitate just seems to bring us back up, so I don't know. Try to use it. I just don't want to waste it. You cannot climb up here. Can we only use a rope to climb up? And then climb up here. So we have to fall down the pit? Doesn't make a lot of sense here. We should be able to throw a rope down. Alright, let's get our protections back on. And who knows what we'll find down there. That's the queen. Maybe there's a king. They haven't been using magic, so. Let me try it here. Right on the edge. Nope. Just drop down. Look, I can't even see the hole here. Let's try it here. Ah! Good. Your eyes see an incredible sight here. Ferrin's daughter is sitting there, surrounded by a large number of Tornaks, all behaving like little puppies. She's playing happily with them, dirty and rather thin, but apparently quite happy. You can only think of one explanation. She must have the ability to communicate with animals. Okay, can we tell her not to have, like, 30 of them attack us? No. What did I do? Where's the little girl? Ha ha ha! Look at that. Alright, well, I'm not used to the song going on and on like that. I'm gonna try to avoid them. We don't have the monster thing lit up, notice. Was that her in the middle? Surrounded by the Tornaks, Ferrin's daughter comes towards you. Who's this girl have a name? It's unbelievable. She does not want to come home with you. She talks excitedly about her new playmates and how much fun she has with them. As Citrine reaches for her hand, the Tornaks start to growl threateningly. You begin to draw your weapons, and Citrine starts to talk to the child about her parents and a good meal prepared by Mummy. The words have an effect. The little girl complains loudly about the strange food which her friends have brought and declares firmly she wants to go home right now. The Tornaks quiet down so quickly that you would think she had switched them off. They do not attack you on your way back. Finally, you enter Ferrin's house again. Oh, thank God. You have just come out of the cellar when Ferrin and his wife rush towards you. The joy they feel is indescribable. They take you in their arms and hold you tight for minutes. Take the daughter in the arms and hold tight. You explain what happened, that the Tornaks sometimes seal their corridors again, and what an incredible influence the child had on the beasts. The happy parents thank you again and again, and Ferrin waves Citrine to him. I want to talk to her first. Oh, the little kid's there. I want to talk to the kid first. The little girl recognizes you again at once and says, I am bored. Can't you take me to my friends? Nope. Can't do that. Ferrin's wife wraps her arms around you and stammers, I do not know the words to express my thanks, noble adventurers. I had such little hope. Bless you. Bless you. You see a powerful dwarf who is playing happily with a hammer weighing at least 20 kilograms. Not even his thick beard can hide his broad smile. Yay. You have made us the happiest dwarves on the moon, friends. What an incredible story! What strange abilities are slumbering in my daughter. But let me give you something more solid by way of thanks. He pulls out an artistically worked bow. It is made of a dark wood and a strange metal, which shimmers in every color. I made this little treasure a short time ago from the best wood and the last remains of Lamidra. Whatever that is, I'm going to write that down. I don't know what Lamidra is. Is that the name of their ship, I guess, maybe? The remains of their ship? Lamidra equals ship, question mark. This metal was produced by magic by the famous ancestors of my family. The bow is light in weight so that anyone can use it, and the best thing is it does not need a bolt. I guess it's a crossbow. With these words, he hands the weapon to Citrine. It's surprisingly light and sits wonderfully snugly in his hand. Farron's hand? Or it's the Treen, because Treen is her hand. Ferrin's crossbow. It is a crossbow. That's probably going to be for our thief, then. I don't suppose there's anything else we can ask him about the crossbow. I don't know what you're talking about. Alright, let's see if he'll answer anything about anything else. Oh, curse. Oh. Daughter? My daughter is very well. We only have to be very careful. Now and again, she wants to visit her friends. Haha. Yeah. Better be careful about how strongly you punish her. She might get her friends after you. So, I mean, if she doesn't want to have supper and wants dessert instead, just let her. She can have the pudding without having the meat. It's fine. Cellar. Let's see if this door Greston. I mean, maybe now that he's in a better mood, he would answer some questions. He doesn't seem to know much. I don't know what Drek is. Is that another dwarf? Dorkirinen? Hello? About the inn, your journey, Kiri, Mage, magic words, about the mine, problem. Problems. They do repairs here. We haven't talked about it. Schnism. Storage cellar. Tempest Fugit. Thing. Tornak. Tools. At least they didn't hit us with status effects. That can get really annoying. Trouble. Alright. Farewell. You are always welcome in my house. Alright, well, give us free stuff. Let's talk to this guy. The dwarf before you is incredibly old. He speaks with a trembly voice. He is the really old one. Have you heard? The little one is back again. We're responsible for being back again, so... Yeah, I think we heard. Alright, I think this... We can only buy things from him, right? Can we speak to you? Is there any more dwarves here to speak with? Before we... Oh, I have to examine that, too. Oh, they're happy now. Are you the old one? You look different when you sit down. I think it is. Yeah. The little one is back. Oh, so we have this, but it doesn't need bolts. Damage plus 30. Oh, it's only 3 grams. Wow. It's the same as this, but it needs no ammunition, and it's only 3 grams. I mean, what if I use magical arrows? Will it use them? I mean, it's a crossbow, though. Alright, I want to identify it. Who does that? Valden? Identification, wrong area. Oh, we need to be in sleep. Alright, we have to go. Enjoy your family being reunited. Well, I'm not taking you over there. Hell no. Are you a different one? Welcome, heroic travelers. Naturally, we have special prices for you. Come to the counter if you want us to repair anything. Yeah, I was hoping we'd get some kind of discount. Before we get attacked by wasp thingies. I'm gonna get into a camp menu. Identification. Ferrin's crossbow. Magical bonus weapon 3. And attack is plus 15. Sweet. That is pretty awesome. I wanted to identify the swift stabbers too. If it's just a weapon or if it has magical properties as well. Magical weapon bonus 3, speed plus 15. Okay, he had a feeling it was like that. Alright, let me just, he's got one left, I'll just identify the other one. Ah, I failed. I just want to have it identified, you know, so in case we sell one and we forget what the other one does, just have them both identified. This one. Come on. Yay. The same, obviously. It's late. Gonna sleep one more time, actually. Just to make it morning. Okay, that's the way out. I'm going to call an episode here. Thanks so much for watching, guys. We'll be looking for door... the other door. I forget what it's called. Weird door, Keridan, door, Garestin, or something like that. We'll be looking for that next. It's supposedly southwest of here. So yeah, we're going to be leaving town. And I know there's the mine over there. But, we don't have a key, right? Yeah, we need the key. So we need to go to Dor Garestin, whatever it's called, which is southwest of here. I have an idea of where it might be. Hopefully it is really there. I have no idea what kind of monsters we'll be facing outside the city walls. I can only imagine. So we have to deliver a letter to Kire's wife, missing wife, who he believes is in or near that other dwarven town. So that'll be next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.